This is gonna be a long video. It's fine. Okay. Hi.
Hi.
Okay, so I'm gonna talk about like a gift guide type of thing, like Montessori inspired gifts and like stocking stuffers. I'm all locked out because I have notes because all my notes were on my damn phone. Hey, don't touch that. It's gonna move. Get away from it so it doesn't move. Let's see. Okay. Also, I'm gonna add, because I talk a lot, some of my like personal ideas and like choices for the holidays. Yeah, so a lot of it is like Montessori inspired. So this is just what works for us and our family, and obviously just do what's best for you and your family. It's just ideas, you know?
Look.
Yeah, don't touch that button. Okay. Santa.
Santa.
Yeah, we're gonna talk about Santa. I already explained
Christmas,
yeah. I already explained. Yeah, this is your tree. Yeah, you can decorate it here.
Yay.
Here, go decorate it right there. The ornaments. Not right now?
Sit.
Oh, you want to sit? Okay. So I explained last year on my Instagram. I have a highlight if you want to go look at it. But basically what we're going to do with Blair growing up, like about Santa, it's not the biggest deal in the world. We're not going to do the whole Santa's real guessing game, you know, be good for Santa, or if you're not good, then Santa's not gonna bring you a present, or he comes down the chimney. Like, we'll do the stories, and we're gonna do everything, but basically, as even as little as she is right now, we're gonna tell her that it's all fake, it's pretend, it's a fantasy. It's just a fun tradition that a lot of people like to do. It's a game we like to play every year. I don't want my kid thinking that somebody is gonna come into the house in the middle of the night while she's asleep to bring her presents. And it's not harmful or a bad thing, you know, but it's just our choice. That's just what we wanna do. As she's older and gets older and older, like, ask every year, like, you want to participate in this and Santa? We could do cookies for Santa. We could do cookies for Santa. We could, you know, read all the stories about Santa. And she loves it right now, but we're always telling her, even though she doesn't understand right now, she's gonna grow up hearing, you know, just what we're teaching her, like everything else, like it's not real. Baby. Also, another little note about that is kind of like, it's like a trust thing with parents. Like, you have to kind of break the news to them when they're older, or they find out in like a weird kind of traumatizing way sometimes. Like, wait, Santa's not real? Or you have to sit there and be like, so we've been lying to you your whole life because we just wanted you to have fun, but it's not even real. And it kind of kills the magic, I think. It's not bad if you do that or want to, you know, it's not a bad thing. I'd just rather tell her the truth all the time, even when she's two. I just don't want to lie to her. Even if it's just for fun, I still think it could be fun when you're telling her the truth. Like, it's a fun game and tradition that we play. And do you want to play it? It's fun. It's like a magical story. And anyway, she stopped the video. It's just like a magical story. And this is what comes with it. Family events that we could do, presents, the stories, Christmas tree, the decorations, the lights. Another part of Christmas that we chose and talked about, and everything that I talk about, me and her dad discuss thoroughly, and I don't just make all these choices and just like, I think this is what's best, and oh yeah, sure. Like, we talk about these things and how we want to raise our baby. And we're not gonna raise her in the religious part of this day is about, you know, Jesus, or we're not religious people. And that's just our choice that we're not gonna do that. We're just doing just the fun tradition part of it. And yeah, that's our choice. So one of the things that I did last year that I want to do every year until she's like 45, a December 1st basket. So, Blair. So instead of giving them like a boo basket for Halloween, you give them all their Halloween pajamas and their Halloween toys, and Halloween's really big to me. So it's kind of like that, but instead of doing it like on Halloween or on Christmas or Christmas, you know, Eve, where they get all their holiday, I don't really want to open a present on Christmas and get like Christmas pajamas. Like, it's over. It's cute, but like, I'd rather do it on December 1st. Instead of giving them all that stuff like the day of, I want to do it on December 1st, so like throughout the month she can have her Christmas pajamas, her little Christmas books, and yeah, it's just she can enjoy it throughout the season instead of here it is on Christmas Day, here's all your Christmas stuff. So in the basket would be like Christmas pajamas, Christmas books, any that you have from last year, or any new ones, whatever, or any like holiday plushie or a doll, or use the dolls they already have and put something festive on it. It doesn't matter. It's just cute. It's a cute thing. Oh yeah, you could also put like Play-Doh, red and green Play-Doh with like little stuff from the Dollar Tree, like little things. Easy. Socks, slippers, or something like this. This is like, how much is this? $25 or something. And like little shatterproof ornaments or cloth ornaments. And I put them in a little basket. She decorates it and then she takes it apart and decorates again. She hangs her little bracelets on there. She hangs all her little things on there. Okay, also the same type of thing as like a December 1st box. A lot of people do Christmas Eve boxes, like the night before Christmas. Have everything ready, you know? Just like pack it all up again. And if you found any cute new little things added in there, and then snacks, like last year I did Cheerios because she was just a baby. And that was her favorite. But you could do like their favorite snacks, or if you have older kids, like add popcorn and hot cocoa, like a holiday cup. Just cute, okay? Okay, so gifts. Okay, these babies and kids and toddlers, they're interested in more than we really think. Like a lot of people are just like, oh, my kid wouldn't like that. Oh no, if it's not Paw Patrol everything, they hate it. They won't like it. Like, give them a chance. Obviously get your babies whatever you want. I talk more about that stuff on my Montessori highlight stuff on Instagram. This YouTuber named Holly Hill, on one of her videos she said like her mom used to do this thing with them all the time, and it was something you need, something from the heart, and something that you want, just to keep it like simple and not be overwhelmed with like Christmas and presents and all that. So I thought that was like a really nice idea. There's one that says something they want, something they need, something to wear, and something to read. Just to not get overwhelmed and wrapped up in the whole like craziness of presents. Craziness of presents. Like, it doesn't have to be 12 gifts each child. I remember when I was little, my Nina used to take me and my cousins to this homestead museum. They did all these Christmas activities. It was so cute. little popcorn and cranberry chain. You would make those, confetti eggs. They would have all these different holiday crafts at tables, like all these treats. I would remember that. I remember that till this day, like more than what my mom would, or her would get me for Christmas. It's just the vibe. It's the memories. It's spending time. It's experience rather than, you know, toys. Toys are fun too, but I'm just saying. Be more like appreciative, I guess. I don't know. I don't want to say the wrong thing here. But I know, I've seen kids, not in a mean way, but they expect a lot. Like, they expect the most. Or they count presents, you know? Like, it's us sometimes. Like, we turn the holidays into this crazy thing that it doesn't, it's not. It doesn't need to be. Oh, also, so I posted, a lot of people have seen my little, we did like a, me and my mom did like a Halloween party after Halloween because my little sister was sick, so she didn't go trick-or-treating and she didn't have a fun October at all. She was sick, so we felt really bad, so we did this little party and it was so cute. Like, it was just us. Oh, thank you. It was just us, but do something like that to make it special if you don't want to get like a million gifts, or you just, I don't know, it's just a cheaper alternative. Or you can do it anyway, even if you do get a lot of gifts. Holiday desserts, candy, the food, a piñata, like the themed activities or family games, like you all have to play together. And then you could do like one gift or two gifts each person. Just because it's, I don't know, it's fun, it's cheaper. You could watch a Christmas movie together or play holiday music throughout the whole day while you're baking cookies. Just make it like a whole vibe, you know? Like, it doesn't have to be so stressful, like, oh my gosh, we didn't get these presents out here. And then the kids open the presents and they're just like, okay, like, thanks. And then the rest of the day, they're just stuck on the present, which is, that's fine too, but, you know, just options, okay? Just spend time with your family. Spend time together. Okay, so I talk a lot. Now to the gifts. Now to the gift ideas. Sorry. Some could be for like babies or older than two, but mostly this is just like, you know, toddlers. For 2 year old, like my baby. Okay, the first gift idea would be a bike, like a baby bike, like little, the bee buggy from Target. That's what Blair has. I'm gonna put in little pictures of all the stuff I'm talking about. That's a good gift. It's very cute. She's had it forever. Yeah, but, or a wagon. We got her a wagon for her first birthday. It's like a walker wagon, like a little push toy thing, and it does a little like click click click. It clicks when she pushes it to help them start walking, but she still uses it around the house. She puts her little plushies in there. Really cute. And a lot of people get those, like, what is it? Those things where the kids sit in there and it's like activities all around them. Walker, baby walker. I don't know, but I did not want one of those for Blair, and it's, I feel like they're not really walking. Oh gosh, yeah, they're not really walking, they're just being held and moving their legs around, which when they're ready to stand up and hold on to something, I think a walker, like a good quality walker, is very, it was helpful, obviously. Blair's over here climbing. Climbing. Next gift. The Pickler triangle. We got ours from Etsy, and it's so beautiful. I love it. She plays with it every single day, and it's a little bit scary, but they have to figure it out. I think it's great to It's great practice, and you can get it as little as any age, actually. Like a baby mobile thing, you could hang little things under it and just lay the baby under there on a blanket. Just buy this one thing and know they're gonna grow into it. You could play on this until she's like 7 or 8 or something. Like, they're just good quality, and yeah, it's really nice and really good. And there's also like attachments you can get if you have like a bigger house or a bigger playroom. Different slides, ladders, a rock climber thing. Like, there's just a lot you could do with them. A lot, but highly recommend. Like, it's one of my favorite things we ever got her. So yeah. Instruments, like, perfect at all ages. Everybody, instruments, amazing. We're gonna get her a new piano for Christmas. That's gonna be like probably her like big gift, a nicer piano. She's had one for like over a year already. I think it's the Bee Toys, or is it, from Target? And it's good, but you just open the top right here. A lot of like kid pianos come with all the extra buttons and different things, and like, I don't know, I don't really like that at all. But this one only had one annoying button. We're getting her this one instead because it doesn't have any extra things. It's just the piano, like, just so she could just play the piano and do what it's meant to do. And piano, perfect. Baby dolls and like baby accessories, like little bottles and diapers and just baby stuff. We put her doll in like a little basket, and I gave her a blanket from this little burp cloth, actually, from when she was born, and she just wraps it up, and it's so cute. But that's a good gift. A sensory table. We got her a sensory table. It was this exact one, actually, and it was really nice. Like, it did everything. A good gift. She played with it for a while, but usually we have a small space here. Usually when I do sensory things for her, like just little theme things or, you know, just messy things, I usually just use like bins, like a white bin. And she just sits on her little mat in her room and plays with that. A broom and a dustpan, okay? I'm not telling you, like, you need to teach your kids to clean right away, but they like to do what we're doing, and they love it. I got this one from the Dollar Tree, and she plays with it every single day. Next is books, obviously. Books. Yeah, here's one of her books. Insects. This is one of her favorite books ever. I like this Jill McDonald. We have like a lot of her books. Okay, so yeah, books, best gift, any age, okay? Blocks, stacking toys, good for babies, good for toddlers. They use them forever. A shape sorter is great. Blair, we already donated Blair's because she already knows how to do all of them. We could have kept it and she could have still played with, you know, the things that came with it forever, but somebody else could use it. Okay, the next one is light up shoes. Every kid loves light up shoes. Even if you don't think they're cute, there's some out there that are cute. She's good everywhere. Like, she's oddly well behaved. Right now she's very excited because I don't do this. I don't have my phone out and usually make videos. This is not like a common thing. So she's like, oh, what's that? She thinks it's funny, but she's just oddly well behaved everywhere. Even if she wasn't, who cares? It's fine. Babies and kids are, I don't care. But if she sees the shoe aisle or kids' shoes, especially light up shoes, because we're looking at them, she will literally cry. She wants it so bad. She had these ones. Ow! She had these ones for a while, and she still has them. They still fit her, but we're getting her sit down. We're getting her these ones for Christmas, and these are the ones she cried the hardest for, and we didn't get them for her because she has a lot of shoes, and we don't need to get them for her because she cried, but we remember that she loves them, and she'll be very excited. This one is Picasso tiles, like Magnum tiles, Picasso tiles. They're really cool. They're just really cool, and we got some from Michaela a long time ago, and she really liked them. And there has some, ow. But yeah, really cool for everybody. This matching game, we used it. I put it on her her shelf for her, like her activities I had out for her. And I would put the cards in like a little container, and then the just the little matching thing. What is it? I don't know, the thing with the damn pictures on it. And so she could take it out and match the pictures to the thing. And as she got older, we started playing like a bingo type of thing with her. So we'd get like a little bag and put all the pictures in it and get two different cards. And we'll pull it out, like, who has the sun? And we have to look, and she'd be like, I do, like, bingo. It's really cute, and all the pictures are real. And yeah, I love it. My mom got it for her, so yeah. Okay, next would be a tea set and play food. So cute. Blair probably plays with this like every day too. We got this one from Target. Very cute. When Michaela turned 3, I think, I got her a different tea set, and I made her handmade felt like cookies and bread, and just so cute. I'm gonna do the same for Blair. Hopefully I can have enough done by Christmas, but if not, it's fine. It takes time. It takes time and effort. I tried to look for some felt play food on Amazon, but they just like don't exist. They're all on Etsy, like handmade and very beautiful and expensive, yeah. But they're very nice. Maybe I'll share a video, I'm not sure, but yeah, so that's cute. Also like pots and pans, like the Melissa and Doug pots and pans. I might get that. She's trying to climb through the tripod. Don't climb through here. Don't climb through there, okay? The Melissa and Doug pots and pans. I'll probably get her that. And make her like some little pasta, like fake food, just something easy. There's this lock and latch. It's like a little board activity. I might get that for Blair, but I like these better because they're individual and they work on one lock or latch thing at a time. And it's way more expensive. Like it's, these things are really expensive for. Well, it's understandable. They're very nice and good quality. Another one is puzzles, like shape puzzles. I got these for Blair when she was last year. And I like them because you can introduce it one at a time, like work on the circle. It's super simple to us and like, that's not fun. That's boring. It's just a circle. Like, they're brand new people, okay? They don't know anything. This is fun to them. And once they master it, it's good. It's good for them, okay? Like, I'm not gonna get into it, but these are good puzzles. They're good puzzles. And then you can start introducing more at a time. And then once they get older, you can introduce like animal puzzles where the little knob, the little puzzle piece is more complex for them. And they have to like, move their hands in different ways and maneuver, you know, the piece or number. She has a number puzzle. She doesn't really need to work on it anymore because she's mastered it already, but she still likes it. Alphabet puzzles. Puzzles. We got her this puzzle thing. I got it for her when she was like a baby, but we just had it stored away for a while because it was really cheap. We found it like at Marshall's for really cheap. And I knew I would want it for her when she got older. And it's like a 3-piece puzzle, like very simple, very easy. And all the and they're very little, and all the pictures are like realistic, like what I want. Obviously all these puzzles, try your best, do what you want, but I would try my best to get realistic pictures, things that just don't look like this, because like animals don't look like that. I think it's confusing and ugly. It's ugly. Okay, anyway, a dollhouse. I wanted to get Blair a dollhouse for her birthday that just passed in October. Unless you get those plastic hot pink weird dollhouses, I don't know. It's just, I don't like stuff like that. They're fine. It's a dollhouse. It's great. Dollhouse. Good. But I just wanted something that we could have that's very nice and very good quality and can last throughout her getting older, and we can make changes to it as she gets older. And I found this one on Amazon for like $180 something. I found it on OfferUp. This lady was selling it for $20 or $25, and we went and picked it up and spray paint. We cleaned it and did all the things, and we spray painted it, and we got her little furniture things for it. We just added stuff to it, and she has all her little people for it, and it's very cute. It's very cute. She plays with it every single day. She loves it. And also something else, the barn that Blair has is like $45 at Target. We found it at Marshall's. They always have them at Marshall's. We got it a long time ago, and I just went the other day, and they still have them. They have even more now. They're $20 at Marshall's. So I don't know what that's about, but it is like a plastic thing, and it comes with these ugly, fugly little weird toys. But Blair already has her farm animals and all her little animals that we've collected for her. You okay? I'll push you after, okay? But she has her own little collection already of the animals that we got for her. And we donated the other ones. But yeah, Marshalls. Don't sleep on Marshalls, okay? Or TJ Maxx. You could sleep on Ross if you want, because I don't like that store. I don't go in Ross, and I don't go in Walmart. Anyway, another one to kind of be like an add-on to a dollhouse and the barn part, I guess, would be people. Like, people. She only had a few for like a very long time. She has her own little collection of people. She got a lot for her birthday. That's a good gift. These are all the people we bought her. What? These are all the people we've got her. And this is how she plays with the dollhouse. I'll put in videos and stuff. But yeah, very cute. And I'm annoying, okay? I'm extra, but I love that. I love that for me. I get her stuff that we like, so we don't have a lot of like ugly things around. But she also has the things she likes. She has a bunch of colors. She has every single thing she needs for her age and everything. She's a very happy baby. Some of them have freaking crazy wings or like mermaids or anything weird. Like, another one is stuff for dress up, like little princess outfits, or like a doctor, a chef, firefighter, like stuff like that. And they could keep in their little collection to play dress up, like, or an astronaut. Oh, I want to get that for Blair. Okay. Another one is for like more, you could start it when they're very young. I got both of these for Blair. It is a ball tracker. And she had a permanence box first. It's so simple. It's the basics. It's part of all the Montessori stuff that I talk about more in my highlight on Instagram. So those are very good for just so they can learn the basics, their hand movements. It's more for babies, but she hasn't had the ball tracker for a little bit, but I'm pretty sure if I brought it out right now, she would really want to play with that all day. A purse or like a little wristlet thing. We got her, she has her own little collection already of like little bags and wristlets and clutches. She's taking them around with her. She likes taking them when we go out, and you can put just like little, you can put little cards in there or little pictures, like just cute. Cute. Oh, it's right here. Oof. We got her this one like a long time ago. Can attach it to her little stroller. It's just really cute. And she has her little picture in there. Pascal. This is gonna be a long video. It's fine. Okay. The last one I have for like a gift is this writing drawing toy. I don't know the name for it, but I found it at Marshall's or TJ Maxx or something for very cheap, like $8. And she recently lost the little, what is it called? Stylus for it. Just have to find a different one at the Dollar Tree or something. But you could draw on it and you press the little trash button and it just disappears. She loves it. I got one for my sister, my little sister too. So now for stocking stuffers that I would get for what? And this one could also be included in like a gift, like a big gift, because I don't know. It's like a big thing. It's probably the most expensive gift on this list, but I think that tickets are a good present because it's an experience. It's more time to spend together. It's somewhere to go, to look forward to. It's a whole thing. It's not just a bunch of things or a bunch of expensive things you could spend money into an experience. Anyway. So Disneyland tickets are very expensive, but I think that's a good gift because Disneyland is the best place. Anyway, that's a good gift. It doesn't have to be Disneyland. It could be movie tickets. It could be for the aquarium, the zoo. Let's see. Knott's or whatever. Six Flags is not, it's fun, but it's not like for babies or kids. So yeah, tickets. I think that's cute. Like, oh, surprise, we're going to Knott's tomorrow. Or whatever. I don't know. I guess that would be in the gifts and not really stocking stuffer unless you go print out the ticket to make it like extra special or something. I don't know. I think it's cute to have to go and make memories. You know, going way down from that. Now here's a stocking stuffer, is a spinning top. It's not boring, okay? My baby loves it and she plays with stuff like this. Like a top, that's like such a old people thing. Like back in my day. Anyway, it's simple, but she's too, like, it's fun. It's fun for her to watch. It's fun to play with. Like, it's fun, okay? Whatever. Also, those little flip-pop things. You know, when you used to go to, like, Chuck E. Cheese, or you used to use your little tickets to get whatever, little toys. They're those little, I don't know the name for it. There's pictures and videos I'll put in, but you like flip it, it's a little piece of rubber and it like pops. That's like Blair's number one favorite thing right now, like this whole week. She loves it. We got it from Dave and Buster's with her uncle's little tickets that he had. Next one would be animal figurines. Obviously, we collect them still for Blair. We like the Schleich brand. They're all realistic, they're very nice. Yeah, animals, she's gonna play with them forever. I want the ones that we get for her to be like really nice and good quality and look real. So Schleich is a good brand for animals. Tubes. I haven't got any for Blair yet, but tubes. But they're tubes, little tubes with little, they have animals from everywhere, like themed tubes. They have this organ one, like with human organs. You could even print out little cards and laminate them and use the little miniature figurines that come in them to like match, match the toy. Bubbles. Oh, she turned and looked. She's gonna make me go get them. But they're bubbles and they're for babies. They're like 18 months plus, I think, because they don't spill. It's this little thing of bubbles. It's perfect. Bubbles that don't spill. Art supplies. Stocking stuffer, perfect. Some markers, stamps, crayons, new crayons, smelly crayons, smelly markers, all the things. Play-Doh, perfect. Play-Doh. We do a lot of Play-Doh little activities here, themed, seasonal. Play-Doh. Die-cast cars, those are good. It's another like a Montessori aligned because they're realistic. They look exactly how the damn car would look in real life. Miss Blair has a few. She has an airplane too. And we recently got her this other car. It's not a die-cast car. It's for those little cute little creatures, those little like bunnies and those little woodland. And she puts her people in there and it comes with a little stroller and little coffee cups. It's just the cutest thing ever. And the last thing for a stocking stuffer would be those Imagine Ink little books or Water Wow. Like you put the water in the little brush and it's like a magical little thing. It helps a lot, like when we're out and she has to like be in the stroller or something to give her something to do. Those are all my stocking stuffers and all my gifts. So yeah, what else do you want to say? Thumbs up, nice, thanks. Obviously get whatever you want for your babies. These are just my thoughts and ideas and stuff I know that we like and enjoy, or things I'm going to get this year. So, yeah. Say Merry.
Merry.
Christmas.
Merry.
Bye.
Bye.
Dream is a wish your heart makes when you're fast asleep.